Hi viewer, I welcome you to Ring TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies from 3. Lesson number 1, the topic it is demand and supply. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Today we are just going to look at the objectives, lesson objectives. We are going to look at the concept of demand and the determinants of demand of the commodity. Now, we start by looking at what is demand. Demand, it is the quantity of a commodity the consumers are willing and able to purchase at a particular price within a specific period of time. That is what we refer to it as the demand. They should be having that will and be able to buy the commodity at a certain price within a given period of time, maybe a week, a day. They have that will and they are able to buy it. But when we talk about a consumer is willing to buy and he does not be able to manage to buy, or he doesn't have the purchasing power, it is known as the desire of goods and services. So when we talk about the desire and demand, these are two different things. Demand, you should be willing and able. But when I talk about a desire, I'm willing, but I'm not able. So that is the difference between a demand and what I'm desiring. Law of the demand. When the price goes up, you happen to get the demand of the commodities goes down. And when the price goes down, you happen to get the demand goes up. So, the law of the demand, the relationship between the price and the quantity is inversed. So that means, one should go up, another one goes down. That is the law of the demand. What are the factors that influences demand? These are the determinants of the demand of the commodity. One, the price of the commodity. Already you have seen that when the price increases, the demand will decrease. So demand decreases with increasing price of the commodity, and when the prices decrease, the demand will increase. So that is the reason as to why I'm saying vice versa is true. So when the demand or when the price is high, the demand goes down. When the price becomes low, the demand goes up. Number two, it is the level of consumers' income. When consumers' income goes up, consumers are able to purchase huge quantities, so they are willing and they are able, leading to an increase in demand. But when we look at their income, when it goes down, you are going to get that the purchasing power goes down. That means that the quantity they are going to purchase decreases. Number three, consumer income distribution. When the income is evenly distributed among consumers, the number of people with the purchasing power is high, hence increase in demand. And when the distribution is not even, the number of people with the purchasing power decreases, hence decrease in the demand. Number four, consumers' taste and preference. If consumers' taste changes in favor of product, it demand increases. So in case now the taste here increases, the taste of that commodity increases, you are going to get that the consumers, the demand will go up. Where in case now the consumer's taste decreases or it is not favorable, then you are going to get the demand of that commodity will decrease. Number five, future expectation of price change. If consumers expect the price of the product to fall in future, or its availability to increase, they will buy less. decrease in demand, when now the prices are expected to go down, you are going to get that the demand is going to increase. If at all the prices are expected to go high, the demand is going to increase. In case now the prices, we are saying in case now the prices are expected to rise, you are going to get the demand are going to increase. But expected to fall, the prices are expected to fall, the demand is going to decrease. Number six, the price of other related products. Products interrelate in two ways, substitute or complement. Substitute products serve similar purpose. Thus, an increase in price of one may cause fall in its demand, hence an increase in the other demand. In case two commodities are substituting one another, can be used in to replace the other one, you are going to get that each demand. In case the price of the other one increases, then the demand of the other one will increase. And in case the demand of the other one increases, it will result to the fall of the demand of the other commodity to decrease. Then for the complement goods, in case a product, it is complement, it means increase in demand of one commodity, then it results to the increase of the other, the demand of the other one. For example, products are consumed together are called complement, like car and fuel. An increase in demand of one product results to the increase in the demand of the other product. And when there is a decrease in one of the product, it results to the decrease of the other product. Number seven, it is the size of population. A rise in population leads to an increase in the demand products. So there is that rise in population resulting to high demand, while decrease in population results to the decrease in the demand. Number eight, there is the population structure. The composition of the population in terms of age, gender, determines demand. If the population mainly comprises of old people, demand for goods and services consumed by old people will increase. Where that of the other people, that is the youth and the young people, is going to decrease. Number nine, change in season. Some goods and services are highly demanded in certain time of the year. Especially, umbrellas are highly demanded during rainy season, while during dry season, they are low demand. Assignment for today. Differentiate between demand and desire of goods and services. Number two, explain factors that may lead to the decline in demand of cars from Japan. Number three, explain five reasons that might have led to the increase in demand of destiny and investment product in the market. If at all you want to get the reference, you can go and get the KRB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 3, third edition. If at all you want to contact us, you can get us through the SMS. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook, and you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to Edin TV.